What's up, everybody? Today's making swordless dungeons. That's today's topic. Been working on this topic for actually the last like 10 days or so. These are alternate gameplay dungeons where you don't use your sword as much as you use your head. You think. You get this item called the lighter and you can light things on fire. You solve puzzles. You get the meditation skill. What's up, Pedro? Man, I'm making some crazy cool progress today. Like, it's so cool to see... Whoops. I'm in god mode. Running real fast. It's so cool to, it's just like a real icing on the top of the cake type of day. You know, all these things are coming together to make this whole... This, all this really, really work. What's up, Teak? So I need to get a save game set up, but there's a lot of cool stuff in these swordless dungeons now. Like, this save game I've already played through this whole dungeon, so you're not seeing it. So let me, get a save game set up so I have appropriate, like, level 1 items, and I'll go into this swordless dungeon, and we'll do this the right way. Stop the 5-hour download when you want to watch a stream. Oh. Note to self. Note to self. This saves one here. This was Xanadu as well. Cool. I can just copy this save exactly as it is. Can even just, I guess, ditch this save game completely. So I shouldn't have any switches for dungeon 3. Oh, this has old switches. Anyways. Okay, anyway, let's just close this. Run the game now. I don't know where we are though. 900, that's fine. Whoa! Gotta turn off god mode. Started me in the ocean. Cool. So I still got my existing save game or save settings and all that, but not the same save. Cool. Alright, I have the sword, some bombs, top hat. Zero guided me to the cave. Okay, so I'm just gonna cheat and put myself. Oh no, I'll just run into god mode and cheat and do it that way. What's up, Arcane? I'm getting set up for working on the swordless dungeons here. Trying to get an appropriate save. I'm working on the swordless dungeons. These are where you solve puzzles. So I'm getting the player there so I can show you what I'm working on inside this dungeon. Okay, outside this cave is a good place to save. So, if I had started from off-screen, I would have seen Zero appear there and walk inside this cave. Okay, oh, and I also should not have any cactus. Oh, good, no cactuses. Great. Okay, so this is, yeah, you will be able to see this play out exactly as it is supposed to be. You know what? The player needs some bombs right here. Somehow, there should be some bombs. Or something that would give them bombs. Maybe there'll be a chest right here. Yeah, I'm gonna put a chest right here, right now. This is gonna have a bomb in it. I don't know how I'm gonna do that, but let's do it. Just in case you get here and you don't have bombs. Oh no, you know what? This is supposed to have zero openness anyways. Yeah, anyways, okay, so you come here. Get the cactus pouch. You can use cactuses for the first time. It reveals a secret. For now, you have to bomb it yourself, but I really want Zero to do that for you. So you can get here without having completed dungeon one, you can get right into this dungeon as well. So there's two choices you have, or two things you can stumble your way across in the world at first in Songbringer. You can either find level one, you're probably going to find it, or you're going to find level two, which is this one. And if you don't find level one, you'll probably find this. Yep, you get the top hat only. Oh, I gotta work on that. That's the first thing I'll work on right now. So, I got everything. So this is super cool. You can the thing that sucks is I haven't finished the art yet. So you're not seeing an animation for when the player throws his top hat. So I'll do that here in a moment. But check this out. This is pretty cool. You can jostle the trees and find secret items. There we go. Bomb container. So this is like a dungeon that plays out where you solve puzzles, and there's secret items, and there's all this exploration and stuff. So it's so cool because it's fun to play, and you don't even have the sword. I love it. But anyways, I got to get that animation working for the for throwing the top hat. Pema, what's up, man? Plan to do anything special for day 365? Yeah, some kind of celebration, for sure. Maybe I'll have a beer on the stream or something. Or a beer, I don't know. Maybe it'll be drunk coding day, huh? Drunk coding day? Day 365? What's up, Rocket Bunny? Rocket Bunny would have me making chocolate milk. It would be chocolate milk day. What's up, Zynger? Oh, it was great. It was great, Pedro. Yeah. Yep. Celebrated here at home. As I usually do. Yes, you want drunk coding day. All right. Day 365. It'll be a celebration of a whole year's worth of actual streams. With the game's actually been a year and a half, but it's only a year worth of live streams. But anyways. Okay, yeah, the animations for the player. Throwing his top hat without the sword. That's going to be the throw animation. We got throw sheath. Oh, there's only three of them. Nice. I love animations where there's only three of them. Alright, so first thing, I like to batch tasks, you know? It helps me to keep on track with things. The concept image, yeah. It looks better than it currently does in the game. But I think I can do a few little tweaks to make the game look really cool as well. But maybe it might look a little different, I don't know. This is just rock throw east, not even sheath. So yeah, I batch tasks. That always helps me do things all at once, right? So I'm doing these three things at once. I'm renaming this file. I find you can get more done when you batch things together. Okay, so each one of these animations is so easy. All I gotta do is erase the sword. Common? No, not common. Put this in heroes. Don't put stuff in the wrong place. It creates a mess. Heroes. Rock throw. Awesome. We got that. Throw north. This is throw. You know what? I'm gonna make this 3D. This is the east one. By at least doing that. What happened here? Huh, I guess that's how it was. It looks weird doing it, but let's see if that feels right in the game. Throw east. Okay, now that those images are all exported, I can go to the profile and change the animation so when he throws, he's got a throw for he's got a regular throw animation without the sword at all. Oh, that's right, these are all a 20th of a second. Makes this a faster animation. Throw east, throw north. Okay, let's see if that works. Jim. it does look weird. Oh, and he's got no idol. Hatless. Oh, we need a hatless idol. Okay, I'm gonna get some of these images. I'm not using clothes because I know I'm gonna be like editing a lot of images right here, right now. Getting all these animations going. So yeah, I wanna open up again the throws and move his foot in that East animation. South is fine, that's right. Okay, so I can clean it up though. North is fine too, cool. What's up, Sean? It's crazy. We're trying out making a small economy for a little 2D city builder. Interesting. All right, it's just the east one. Oh, see, I already did this one. Okay, let's close that one. Don't even save it. It's just the sheath east. Fix those feet. Right, if there's a lot of food and small taxes, people are happy. Interesting. Sounds like a fun game concept. Right? I've never really made city games before. Can't even imagine how fun that would be to like create a city creator. This animation still looks weird to me, but I'm gonna re-export it like that. Okay, yeah, these idle animations, man. We need idle animations. Automismo for rock idle. Hatless. It's just a regular idle, but hatless. Inspired by city skylines? Cool. What city skylines inspired you? Oops. That was all. Ah. Okay. All good. You've already got him standing correctly. That's good. Let's just get the hair. Oh, there's a game called City Skylines? I did not know this. Doop, 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 doop. Doop, 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 doop. Boop, 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 doop, 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 doop. Idle East, idle hatless East. Gotta get this hooked up in the code too. Idle. Hatless. Blacksmith and the artist, each must do his part to mold a new reality closer to the heart. He's like a trash can head. Yes, yeah, a screenshot. Oh, nice. Getting it planned out, set up. Very cool. Getting it started. All right, I'm not sure if these animations will work, but let's see if it does. I'm not sure if I have the skins all set up so it properly does an idle hatless, but hopefully this works and because otherwise I have to fix code, a whole line of code. Why does it save me out here? It's because I kept forgetting to save every time. All right, okay, all right, okay. So I can use the top hat. Oh, it still has the wrong sheath though. no problem, no problem. It's in set hero states. Render system set skin. The sand, right? Yeah. This logic here, I'm trying to get this right. So this is if you have the top hat, but you need to know if, okay, so if a top hat is out and you don't have the sword at all. So we gotta, we need like a bool has sword. Logic puzzles. Okay, so if you even have the sword, then you can do, if you, yeah, you can do this. But if you don't have the sword, it's just hatless. Hope that logic is right. It's a WTF method. Just WTF until it works. Yes! Oh, he didn't have the catch though. Dang, I gotta do the catch. Oh, the catch is like a reverse of the throw, I think. That's a really easy one. Yeah. Oh, this is gonna be great to have this little icing on top of the cake. Catch. Yeah, we got a lot of these catches. Let's just make a catch hatless. Well, same as throw. Wait, 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 wait. Oh yeah, it's just the reverse of throw. I think this one little and this last bit of throw east, throw sheath east, all these, he stands up a pixel. I'm not sure if this is really what. Yeah, I don't think this is right. So let's. Wait a minute, is the hat exactly the same? Yeah, it's just to this should be like just those pixels down one. Okay, let's see if that helped the overall organicness of this animation. To mold a new reality closer to the heart. What do all these icons mean? Second, but I think it helps. Cool, we can throw the hat. Oh, what? Oh, I gotta have run. Run hatless. Run hatless. Okay, run hatless next. So many hatless things. Cannot be ignored. Close all this other the hatless stuff. Check it in so far, too. Actually, no, I'll just do run and then check it in. Throw north. Might as well just save it. Okay. Run. Rock, run. Running. East, north, south. Hatless. Ooh, it's been a minute since I touched these. Quite a while, as you can see from this like gray background and everything. Okay, save that as Hatless Swordless Dungeon. Yes, this is a really cool dungeon, man. It's where you solve puzzles. It's actually fun too. At first, I was so worried. I was like, man, if I take away the sword, take away Jib, and do a totally alternate gameplay style dungeon where you're all, it's all psychedelically inspired, and you do mostly like solving puzzles and finding items and exploring and using your mind, you get in the meditate skill. It's really cool to have that in the game instead of all of it just being combat, you know? It's a mostly combat game still. You got like most of the dungeons are combative and all stuff like that. But I'm trying out this one dungeon so far like this. And I think it's going to be something that's a keeper. It's a keeper. All right. Yep. Yeah. It's not even really my idea. Like Solar Flare told me a while ago. He watches the stream sometimes. He said you should have more stuff that makes it more like Zelda. You know how Zelda had puzzles and stuff like that. He's like, you should have a few puzzles. And then, you know, I've been convinced recently too that puzzles are a good idea. So, I have created all the like the basic stuff that has to go in place to get puzzles to work, right? The world has to be able to place these puzzles. It's a procedural game, so it has to have certain places where puzzles make sense. A puzzle would activate a door or something in the right place in a dungeon to get you through it. And then, like in this special swordless dungeon, it's kind of heavily relies on puzzles. It's a meta puzzle, actually. You have to solve three different puzzles to get the boss door to open, so it's like a meta puzzle. And basically putting all that machinery in place took a while. I've been working all this stuff like the last 10 days, but it's worth it. It's starting to become really fun. Today is the icing on top of the cake day. I'm finally like, yes, things have come together. You know, I can play it. It's actually fun. And it's really cool too, because it's also got the NPC Zero in it. And he's pretty badass. He's very mysterious too. You're like, who the hell? Why is he helping me? Why is this mysterious character helping me? Does this game have choices that affect the game? Yeah. But taking away your basic tool, that's why I find it interesting from it. Oh, yeah, taking away, yeah, I know, right? It's a risk, too. At first, I'm like, oh, my God, I can't just do that. You know? I can't just take away the very first thing that I give to the player. But you know what? Why not? Why can't you? Why can't I at least try this? You know? And it's so far, I'm like, I tried it, and I like it. And so I think there might be, like, up to 3 different alternate gameplay style dungeons. So at least 6 of the dungeons will be regular dungeons where you have the sword, and then possibly up to 3 of them will be this, you know, alternate style. Yeah, right. Yeah, I guess it does take that a little bit. So another one of those choices was adding the ship Songbringer, you know, where you can warp back to Songbringer. I'm like, can you just do that? I guess so. You know, you got to make creative choices, and then you try it out. If it works, cool. If it sucks, maybe you can improve it somehow. If you still try to improve it and it still sucks, don't do it. Just do something else, you know? That's at least my process. It's a WTF method. I just try things out. If they don't work, so what? Try something else. All right, cool. I got these set up so I can make these hatless running animations, and then I think that will be all the animations we need so you can play without the sword. So I'm not even getting my graphics tablet out for these animations because this is like more. Maybe I should actually just do this with my graphics tablet. That would probably be faster, huh? Let's see. For simple mousing like that, is it faster to do this? Probably. What's up, Tom Nook? Thanks, man. Oh, yeah, this is faster. I forgot how fast the graphics tablet is. I was wasting my time there. Yes, it's more tranquil. Exactly, Rocket Bunny, because there's no enemies. There's no enemies. There are traps. So there's traps and there's puzzles. But there's no enemies. There might be a boss. There might be bosses in these. I'm not sure. Will there be a no pants animation? You want the no pants animation? The best pants. All right, so hatless, I named these all, right? Yeah, hatless, east, export, run it, put it in the game right now. Running, we need a running animation. There's idle, revive, turn, running. No, that's the running turn. I want running, run, here we go, run, north, south. This is the run hatless. There needs to be a Rock smooths out his hat hair animation. Yes! Okay, I got an idea for when that's going to be, Salad Dongs. I've been planning on having a celebration animation. So when you beat a boss, he'll like do something cool. So that's a great idea for one of his celebration animations. Like he could take off his hat, smooth his hair back, and then put his hat back on. Just a simple thing, like that plays only when you beat a boss. You know, it's like your reward. Like, woo, you just beat a boss. Here, let's play some animation that never, ever, ever plays anywhere else in the game. Yeah, it shall be done. All right, there's another one done. Atlas North. Last one, South. I think this is the last animation I have to do for all this to work, where you to be able to totally play the whole game without the sword. Play the whole game. I mean, just play the game. Wait, what is this? Why is that color wrong? That's the wrong color. Wrong color. It's not right. Oh, he's too short, too. His hair is 1, 2, 3, 4. You can't tell there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, it was right. Okay. It was right. I thought it was wrong for a second. Ah. Was weird. It's like bald rock. And another one bites the dust. Think that's everything we need to do. What's up, Thomas? I'm making it Swordless Dungeon tonight. So I just finished up the animations, I think, for everything you can do that, so you can now play the game without the sword. It's really interesting. You solve puzzles, you explore, you find stuff, you solve puzzles. Did I say puzzles yet? Can I say puzzles three more times? You escape traps. You learn to use your mind instead of just the sword. Without the hat on, and it looks okay. It's kind of funny when you catch, though. That's kind of cool, anyways. Okay, so actually, I'm finally ready to actually do this. Yes, exactly, Zaldogs. Exactly. Okay, so let's experience this a little bit together, huh? I got things in place. Oh, wait. Okay, I was freaked out there. I was like, why does he have the hat on? Like, oh yeah, that's what he's supposed to have on right now. Okay, does anybody see the puzzle here? So check this out too. This is super sweet. In these swordless dungeons, you can sometimes find hidden items. Detector. Yeah, Thomas, you lose it for this dungeon. Yes, you lose the sword. It's cool, right? Okay, there's another puzzle. Let me show you. So you have to solve these puzzles. If anybody does not want a spoiler alert, these are not very complex puzzles, so I'm not probably not spoiling that much. But anyways, if you're liking this game and you want to play it, and you don't want me to ruin the puzzles for you, this is a big spoiler alert, right? Don't watch this stream. Turn this stream off if you or this YouTube video if you don't want to see how to beat the puzzles in Songbringer. So here's where you get the lighter. And lighter equips to A as well as the sword. So in these swordless dungeons, you have a lighter, and you can also equip the lighter out of the swordless dungeons, but you have to unequip your sword to use the lighter. For now, I might change that so you can just bind it however the hell you want. Like, you can just change it so even the sword could not be bound to A. But yeah, so the lighter can light stuff on fire. And once you can light stuff on fire, solve the puzzles in this dungeon. So that's part of it. This is a meta puzzle. Alright, so I'm seeing, like, on this screen there's too much yellow and orange going on here. I'm gonna come back to this area and fix the yellow and the orange, and I'm also going to add some pillars. I really like seeing the pillars around the edges of these swordless dungeons. It's super cool. I don't know why, but the combination of the pillars and the bushes is really neat. And there's some other stuff, some like desert fauna type stuff that I have drawn already I need to add in here. What's up, Zeok? Thank you, man. What's up, Magic Fossil? This thing's already lit. Thank you, Magic Voxel. Appreciate it. I wonder if there's anything secret up here. Ooh, diamond? I guess there's nothing secret on this area. Yes, Magic Voxel, of course, please post your art. Yes, share your stuff. I'd like to see it myself, and I know there's other people here on the stream that'd like to see it too. And yes, would love to give some critique or advice or whatever, whatever comes to mind. Tom Nook, good, man. I hope it does. Yeah. Well, I'm trying to get the game, you know, released here. Not released just yet, but like, it'll be released this year for sure. There's something wrong with this area. It's like, I think it applied some sky, actually. Yeah, that's what happened. Some sky is right here, and so the shadow mask got set right here. So I gotta fix this area. So anyways, this is a spoiler alert moment for anybody spoiling the game here. I just solved the meta puzzle for this dungeon. And when you solve the meta puzzle, this meditation item appears. And you can meditate. So I'm gonna equip the meditation skill. Meditate near this door. Thomas, no, the lighter does not go empty. It's, you can forever use it. Nice, Magic Voxel. Looks cool. How are you gonna animate it? Yes, Pedro, that is already planned. Thank you, man. Thanks for sharing that idea. But yeah, I'm already planning to do that, because the way, you know, the way that one lighter, the fire lit itself over time, really the only way to make a time-based puzzle is to make it so that the lighters will go out, the fires go out as well. So you would have a trail of flames going or something like that. You would have to do the right flames and trails to get everything to light on fire at once. So yes, that's planned. That's going to be in there, Pedro. There'll be a lot more puzzles. This is a very, very simple puzzle for now. Very simple meta puzzle. Oh, with pillars across different rooms. Now that's interesting. That could work too. Okay, so let's see if this worked. So I want those boss doors to not just disappear right there. I want them to at least fade out when you go to the next screen. I want to take this art as well and make it better. When you stand on this in the swordless dungeon here in the sand, this should blend in with the sand if it's on the ground like this. And it probably does not even need these life chests. But I guess they're okay being there still. And then yeah, once you're done with this dungeon, oh, and Gargoyle does not have a shadow right there. Oh, why did I play the sword noise? I played the sword noise. That's funny. Let's fix that. So Flux, it's a phase. Lift sword, begin, replace the song of the sword, but not if the flux type is flux. Lift sword two. Oh, I mean, if flux is flux, lift sword one. Play the song of the sword, otherwise, don't. The genre is Songbringer? That's a big compliment, Tom Nook. Thank you for saying that, man. I would love to have actually made my own genre. This is not my own genre. You know, there's been several roguelike Zelda-inspired type games, you know, like this along the line. This is more Zelda-inspired than roguelike, but it's both the kind of the same root, same perspective and all that too. Okay, so I think this is ready to check in. That was a lot of stuff that just got added to animations. All these hatless animations for idling, throwing the hat, catching the hat, running without the hat, all that kind of stuff. I fixed that little bug with Song of the Sword, and I also fixed it so you can see the hatless animations. Okay, so I think I should have everything added to the project, and there shouldn't be any new files. What's up with this? That's just modified, right? No, untracked files. Oh yeah, I added all this stuff. Okay. I gotta add all these animations. Undertale and Hyper Light Drifter? Cool. I haven't played Undertale. I loved Hyper Light Drifter. That was an amazing game. For sure. And Super Brothers, yes, definitely always an inspiration. You can always go back and play a little Super Brothers Sword and Sorcery and get your inspired state on. Cool, git commit everything. This is hatless stuff. Hatless and hymns. Sweet. Okay, so the next thing I want to do is to get in here into this dungeon and start playing with the patterns and doing all the things that I mentioned while I did that little run through of that dungeon. There were a lot of little artistic elements that I want to touch up. Patterns also. So it's going to get all right, get status. Yeah, it usually does for me. Especially when I do like stuff like that, like adding a bunch of animations, it's just like, you know, a long get status list. So where to start? Well, I guess I'm going to starting with the save game I had just a second ago. Saves. Wait, no. No, I just want this the current save game I have, but I'm going to take off. So it's got me back at 530. Oh, actually, I want to check something. Right? Yes. That's a good way to put it. I melt for atmosphere. Oh yeah, okay, that still looks good. Cool, that's all good. Tom Nook, you don't really see that much, do you? And it could be better too. There's some things I wish I could do with three, you know, with. But I'm only two dimensions. This is a two-dimensional game, so I can't really do much more 3D-ish lighting. I could probably find some way to do a 2D pixel game, but pull off even better 3D lighting, I guess. I should try and find a way to do that. Yeah, so I'm gonna put an item chest right here. Yeah, let's do this right now. I'm gonna put an item chest right there. Since this DAW, I use Ableton for my DAW. I love Ableton. And my synthesizer that I use is called Massive. It's a VST instrument, you know. Massive's great, but it's kind of old school. There's better synthesizers these days, but Massive still was kind of a was Massive was really popular like in the late 2000s, and it's still I guess it's still popular. I don't know. There's probably better synthesizers out today. Okay, so I'm going to take away the Life Container 3 that I just picked up. I'll keep the compass I found in the bush. I'm keeping it. I'm taking away the meta puzzle that I just solved. Have you considered implementing normal and specular mapping? Oh, normal maps? Yeah, totally. I was gonna do my own normal map shader, and it would just work automatically. You know, like there's software out there that can do it for you. Like for example, Sprite Illuminator. Where are you? But the problem with Sprite Illuminator is that you have to go draw a normal map for every single. Let's see if there's some GIFs or images on this rather than just taking you to the website. Yeah, so Sprite Illuminator works kind of like this. You give it a 2D sprite and you can draw on these normal maps and it helps you draw stuff better. But anyways, every single frame you have to do a different normal map for by hand. And there's no way I could do that with this game. There's so many frames. So I was going to do an automatic one that would just do a simple normal map based on where a light is and just using the edges of sprites. I think I might still do that. I don't know. Thanks, Magic Voxel. Okay, I think I did everything. Oh, I also need to remove the lighter. We don't need the lighter. Where is the lighter? Oh, there it is. And meditate. We don't have the meditate skill. Gosh, there's a lot to take away from this dungeon. Okay, there. We're ready to do this again. And I want to start the player in Dungeon 3. And the sword should be unequipped. Meditate will unequip itself. Both those will be fine. Cool. I think I should save my save game like this. Right? So yeah, I got a couple biodetectors, some bombs, the hat, some cactuses. But that's it. Oh, I have explored this dungeon. Let's take away the exploration as well. That's all gonna be the three. Three, 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 three. All those. There we go. Okay, so that's back to how it was. Let's save that. And now I can go to what room I want to work on next. Oh, and I wanted to work on the cave right outside. That's right. I was gonna make a little life chest or a bomb container or a bombs. So if you get to that point in that cave, and for now that, you know, there's no zero yet. Zero is supposed to appear here and blow open this hole for you if you don't have the bombs yet. But if you have the bombs already, I guess he won't appear. Yeah, that's what'll happen. The game will get smarter. You checked out Baltree? Cool. Right? That's, I know, Jason. Zero? Yeah, Zero is an NPC, Magic Voxel. Zero is this NPC that, let me show you. Wait, oh, I gotta take away this boss as well. There, save that. Put the player, I was just here, but I want to go back to say 430. Let me show you this. His character's name is Zero. He's this mysterious guy. He's actually your spirit guide. You don't even talk to him for a long time into the game. I'm thinking maybe you do talk to him at first, but see how he just magically appeared there on the side of the screen? But he's an actual hero. He's an actual character or NPC. And see, there he appears on this screen too, guiding you into this cave. So yeah, that's who Zero is. Okay, so I've got something where you got like life containers or life, it's called a life chest tile. Yeah, life chest tile. I want to change that to be just a chest tile. Small chest tile or something like that. Wait, chest tile? What is it? No. Oh, it's a life chest. That's all. So I want to change life chest to be just small chest. It's just a small chest, man. That's all. Item has type. By default, it'll be life. Okay, let's do this. It's gonna be called small chest. It'll be smarter about what it has inside it. You know, most of the time it'll just have a. Wait. Let's just do this. Life chest. Most of the time, it'll have a single life or courage inside it. Okay, back here at the bottom of area patterns when it does the entrance for dungeon. Entrance, this is a cave underground entrance 3B. And I just want to do one single life chest tile or small chest. And this thing will be smart enough to know that it should be a bomb if you have it. Otherwise, it'll be some life. Wouldn't it be nice if the dungeon entrance door is sealed in the overworld? You have to light something in front to open it. No, Thomas, it already does this. No, it already does this. Yes, it's a very mysterious entrance. Let me show you how it all works. You missed the beginning of the stream, but yeah, there's already a sequence where it's all mysterious and there's a cracked wall. Let me show you. First, I'll take away the small chest. All right, I make sure this is in the right place. Nope, it's not there. Are you supposed to be negative two? Did I got the right one? Oh man, wrong area. What is this? Why isn't it here? Where'd it go? I'll show you in a second. I'll show you how it all goes. I don't know what's up with this. Why isn't this? Okay, like what if this was a gargoyle? See you, Tom Nook. Oh, there, it's just in the wrong place. Okay. This should be H2 minus 3 or so. Right, cool. There, it's in the right place. Now make that a small chest. It's kind of interesting seeing this like crazy glowing thing over here. I should probably do a different kind of chest for this area. Okay, now I'll make it smart so it does a bomb when it's inside this underground swordless thing. Oh, that means I have to. Wait a minute. I might be able to do this purely with data. If I make us three small chests. Make a bomb inside. Oh, but this would require that. I also need to require that the player even has bombs yet. So I don't think that'll work. Well, that didn't work anyways. Okay, that means I gotta redo a function. Area.h. Create small chest tile. Area creation. We need a very small function for that. And I need to hook up that method tile small chest becomes a create small chest tile and take away that. Alright, so I'm going to get the item component. On Seed Thomas in Dungeon 1, I wasn't able to get into the room to unlock the boss door because I had no bombs for the pillars and didn't find any in the dungeon. But you loved it. Okay. Okay, good. Well, I'm glad you loved it then, because I guess I shouldn't fix anything then, if it's not broken. Good, I'm glad that... So did that kind of add to your exploration? Yeah, and it didn't make things too easy. Good. Yeah, yeah. Gotta be at the right difficulty level, right? Some things should be sort of a little bit difficult. Some things... I really don't think things should ever be really, really, really difficult until maybe the end of the game, you know? That's the goal, at least. Item component. If this thing's not empty, we're going to automatically set the type. So, item. Basically, we just want to change it if it's the swordless dungeon. So, if flags. If this is a sword, no, this is not going to have the swordless flag. Okay, if it's the entrance, is underground entrance, area pause.z. I guess, yeah, if it's just an underground entrance and the player has auto ref hero 0, and if hero.gear.count k item bomb, no, wait, no, just count bomb containers, count bomb containers greater than 0. Then we can put a bomb in here. Item type equals K item bomb. There, you're guaranteed to have a bomb at least in this place. Should make things pretty obvious how you get in here. I think there's also kind of a basic expectation that with the procedural generated game, some seeds will be harder than others. Yeah, that's true. Kind of like how in Diablo 2, sometimes you get a seed where you can bypass an entire area because the stairs, the next area spawn close to the entrance. Yeah, I don't remember that. That never happened to me. I played a lot of Diablo 2. That was a long time ago. Okay, so let's see if this should have a bomb in it now. Nice! And if I don't have bombs at all, if I have no bomb containers yet, for now, this will have to be a mystery. But what I want to happen is for Zero to appear and he places a bomb and opens this up, even if you don't have bombs. So you're rewarded for finding this early on in the game, if even if you don't have the bombs yet, you know, you can still do something with this area. What's up, Steve Jeremy? I did, right? I got some of these on. Suspenders. Right, okay, so I don't have any bombs and it just gives me a heart now. Okay, so let's go back. Let's say I have a bomb container. I'm cosplaying. So Thomas, here's what I was talking about. Okay, wait. Let's get back. Let's take away the cactus container as well. So I have no cactus containers. Oh, also I'll put the player back out at the overworld so we can see this all from the beginning. So this is what I was talking about. There's already a mysterious sequence going on here where you see Zero and he guides you to this place. And this is a spoiler alert. If you guys don't want to be spoiled, I'm giving away puzzles and secrets and a lot of stuff today's stream. So don't watch if you don't want to be, if you want to be surprised. This is a swordless dungeon. This is kind of a unique, it's not a unique, it's just a risk. It's a creative risk to change the game where you don't even have the sword during one of the dungeons. But it's really fun. I like it. So there, you see Zero appear on screen a couple times. He guides you into this cave. So far, all I have in the game is the sword, the top hat, bombs, and like maybe a biodetector or scanner drones or something like that. But basically all you have is a sword, bombs, and top hat. You find this cave though because Zero guides you here. He's totally mysterious. Who the heck is this guy? Why is he guiding me? You find the cactus pouch. This is your first time you find the cactuses in the game. So the game no longer just gives you cactuses randomly. Until you have a cactus pouch. So if you've never collected the cactus pouch, you're not just gonna get cactus drops anywhere. So you get the cactus pouch and that enables you to hold 3 cactuses. And then as you progress through the game, you can find more cactus pouches. And so it makes it kind of a cool collectible item there. But so, what did that bind to? Y? Let's use, or G. So when you're in this cave and you use this, and it's like, oh, there's a crack in the wall. Luckily, I've already completed dungeon one, so I have the bombs. If I didn't have any more bombs, I could pick one up right here and use it here. What's that do? Nice. And this is how you get into this special dungeon, the swordless dungeon. So Zero's gonna appear right there, and he's gonna basically. Not exactly quite sure what he's gonna do there, but the whole point is that this dungeon is all about Zero. It's all about that NPC. So you wake up here, you don't have a sword, there's Jib's not there. This is totally different, right? And this is where you get the lighter. And the meditation skill. So that's good to get to this point in the game, and I can save right here, and I want to focus on this area starting here. This is the first puzzle area. First thing I want to do here is play with the pattern a little bit. This pattern is good, but I want it to be a little, maybe a little tighter or less. I'm not sure. Oh, this bottom would be cool to not do this pathway as well. Oh, but it is neat to have access to these bushes. Oh, but you wouldn't need the bushes for this kind of area. Okay, so I'll save here. Yeah, Yeah, so it'll get better too. Once there's more, there'll be a lot more NPC encounters with Zero that are not even in there yet for this whole sequence. But I'm working more on the mechanics of it all here, like what's, you know, basically getting things right, and also making the patterns look cooler and stuff. Okay, so that's good. I could save that small chest. And going to area patterns. There's the pattern for the puzzle. Here they are, these puzzle patterns. I'm using the same code to generate a circle pattern around here. And I want to make this more flexible. I'll make this into a function I can reuse. But before I do that, I'm going to get a drink of water. I'll be right back. Sore. I'm already tired of standing today. How long have I been streaming already? Why am I sore? It's only an hour and a half and I'm sore. What? Alright, so I just gotta design the circle pattern. So right now I'm talking, let's see what the circle is exactly here. I'm talking about. Calisthenics with Wizard Foo. Everybody! 1, 2. 1, 2. This is the circle right here. There's a little circle of blank in the middle. There's a circle of the opposite of a circle on the outside for parts of this. And then there's these shapes here through the middle. Yeah, it's high contrast. It also has a lot of the game's shader looks really good with it because it's using soft light and some other like Photoshop-y, you know, blending effects. That's the whole game is basically based on Photoshop blending effects. When I first created the game's mockups, I'm like, okay, I kind of want the game to look like this, so I just made a shader that looked like that, and that's why everything kind of looks a little better than it does in my when I make it in pixel art. So like this doesn't look as good when it's in when it's in Photoshop, but when you put it in the game, it looks better because it's got all the shaders. designing this function, I want it to be able to specify the tile type for the inside, the tile type for the radius, and the tile type for outside of the radius. But I want to be able to do that for the bottom half of the screen and the top of half of the screen. So I guess I could just pass 6 different tile types to this function. Yeah, let's just do that. I'm gonna do 6 different tile types, make one function that does all this in one. Thanks, Steve. So area.h, I think there's something where I already do like a pattern shape. I'm going to call this pattern circle, pointing to the center. Why not just allow mirroring in X or Y or both? I don't know. Just instinct, I guess. I feel like designing it this way, this right now. Mirroring. This is mirroring. See, I don't wanna do mirroring on the X for this function because it's a stylistic choice. The style for the game, I wanna see symmetry on the lower half and the bottom half. When it's out of symmetry for the two sides, man, I don't want to over design or overthink this. But I have been overthinking it for the last like 5 minutes. Like, how should I do this? I guess I could just draw a single quadrant at a time. Yeah. I'll just do a single quadrant at a time. That'll make it all a shorter, and everything. I don't have to worry about mirroring or anything. So quadrant Q, V3I center, int radius, K or tile type, inner tile type radius tile type, outer tile. There we go. There's the method signature I want. Area.h. Let's throw this in area.cpp. Area patterns, actually. We'll put it up at the top near all these other patterns and stuff. And then we'll use it for these puzzle patterns. Reusing code is always a good thing, kids. I'm holding down the X key, trying to get freaking, what's it called, to work. Come on, autocomplete this. I don't want to type this. I'm going to wait so long that you just type it for me. No completions? You suck. May I ask, what are you programming? Hello. Welcome to the stream, man. I'm programming a game called Songbringer. This is a year and a half into making it. This is almost a year of live streams. They're all on YouTube. And I'm making a Zelda-inspired game. What? Pattern circle, man. Pattern circle. What's up? Why didn't I have it? Jeez, I waited that whole time. Area. Pattern circle. Here we go. Here we go. Update. Added in the concept of food consumption. Sweet. Nice, Rocket Bunny. Okay, so now we can do the circle pattern. We got the tile, got the radius, got the center. We're doing a for each tile. There was already none. Capture the quadrant. You don't have the time to play Zelda-like games anymore? What kind of time do you have to play then? Do you still play games at all? We need to capture all these tiles as well. Man, we gotta capture all this stuff. Oh, can't you just use the ampersand key to capture everything? I've never used this before, but I think this is gonna become highly useful right here. But does this capture everything by reference? Does anybody know? Tell me. C++ lambda. Capture all. Oh, except this? Oh, that does everything but this, huh? Which makes sense. Well, I guess this should be okay. If y is greater than, or if r is rated greater than radius. Oh, if this is not the right quadrant, too. Let's start with the quadrant. C++? It's a language. It's a programming language. It's what you see on the screen right here, right now. This is C++. So if the quadrant is less than 2, that means it's one of the southern quadrants. And the y is greater than or equal to h2. We're returning. Let's also do, or if the quadrant is west, which would be 1, or northwest, which is 2. So if quadrant is greater than or equal to 1, well, k, actually we just do quadrant equals k. Southwest or quadrant equals K Northwest. And Y or X is greater than or equal to W2. Let's use greater than actually right there. Both of those return, so that should do the quadrant check right there. That basically makes it so it ditches the function if it's not using the right quadrant. So this thing has to be called 4 times to do a whole screen. Oh, equals, that's what I wanted to use. I didn't want to do them all by reference. I wanted to do by value. Let's check that, see if there gives an error. This is what, I just make this like inner tile or whatever. We get rid of that that warning. You know your medical stuff? All right, man. Cool. Hey, that does work, Steve. This captures this, at least in Xcode's implement. I mean, Clang. Okay, so now that's in place. I could do if r is greater than radius, we're going to do the outer tile. If R equals radius, we do the radius tile. You know what? We don't even need this anymore. We'll just go if R equals radius, R is greater than radius, inner tile. There we go. Cool. Now it should be better. Now we can use the circle pattern circle in other places. Anesthesiologist. Whoa. Yeah, you do. You got to munch. I know. That sounds stressful. Sounds really stressful. That's a lot of responsibility to take on, too, right? You're putting somebody under at that point. Got to make sure they come above under. Okay, so what pattern is this I'm on? You got pizza coming? Sweet. This is the pattern one dot. So let's try this function out. This pattern circle. Come on, why isn't it autocomplete? Oh, there. We'll do for each quadrant. For each quadrant, Q, pattern circle. The center. Center is always going to be the same. Good job. Yes. Good job. Radius 4. Okay. If we're only the outer tile changes. So the inner tile is K tile none. The outer tile or the radius tile is always bush. The outer tile is sometimes if y is less than center dot y, then we do k tile water, or if it's not, then we do k tile pillar. So that should do exactly the same thing as that. Let's comment this out though, just in case. Just leave it around for a second, make sure this works. Oh, and this is. Oh, this is if Q is less than 2. I know, it's still a stressful job. Knocking people out. I'm sure it is. I would be stressed out. It worked. And if, let's see if I flip that, right? If I go the other way around, if there's water on top, pillars on the bottom. Nice. That still looks cool. In fact, it looks so cool that I'm going to do a random thingy right now and make sure all these puzzle patterns are coming out the same. In fact, oh, you know what? Let's see if that was like Steve Trammy's idea is works, right? If I were to do totally different quadrants, I could do like quadrant equals 0 or quadrant equals 3. Why did it do three of them that way? Something is wrong. I must have done the quadrant party wrong. Oh, that's a crazy question, Kojal. Seeing that layout is a big face. Oh, that was kind of cool, right? This is a face. This layout right here. Wait, so it's the column in the middle is a pig nose. Bushes are the eyes. Oh, okay. Ah, it is. It is. It's kind of a smiley face. If it were like, if there were more bushes right here, it would be more smiley facey. What's it look like now? Okay, I must have done the logic wrong because this pattern circles only. I'm only doing 0 and 3. They should be water, and then this other one is still. I must have done this statement wrong. Okay, what if I just go. Quadrant is southwest or southeast. No, it's still wrong. Okay, let's do this one at a time. Let's lay this all out. Unroll this loop. Unroll! This is actually case southeast, southwest, northwest, northeast, and all this stuff. We'll just do them all pillars. Okay, so starting with just one of them, let's make sure just one quadrant works. See, there, that's the problem right there. Quadrant zero did both these quadrants. Oh. Duh, I'm seeing why. Yeah, this logic is all wrong. So what quadrant did I start with? Southeast. Do I have to lay this logic out for each quadrant individually? I guess so, maybe I do. Yeah, I guess so. All right, quadrant is K Southeast. And X I guess less than or equal to W2. Yeah, because it's 21. Okay, yeah, so 20 would be the even. All right, so if X is less than or equal to W2, or Y is greater than or equal to H2? Yeah, equal to H2. Unrolled loop math. This is, there's got to be a more simple way to write this, but I'm just doing it this way because I can't think of the simple way right now. Pineapple. Southwest. Okay, if it's... X is greater than W2... Greater than... No, this is less than, this is greater than or equal to. Yeah, let's do this more simple. I don't want to have to redo these, so is... West is going to be if X is less than or equal to W2. And South is Y is less than or equal to... No, I'm thinking just less than H2. Yeah. So if you're in the Southeast... And it's not south, or it's west. That's a fail. There, this is better to have the logic this way. All right, if you're in the southwest, and it's not south, or it's not west, that's a fail. Pizza guy was admiring my house. I think he's going to come back and rob me since he knows I'm sort of wealthy. Did I use Kappa right? Yes, you used Kappa right. Good job. I didn't even know how to use Kappa for the longest time. Everybody was making fun of me. You don't know how to use Kappa. Okay, so if it's northwest and it is south, or it's not west. Now, if it's northeast and it's south or it's west... There we go. Now this logic should be right. Let's test it all out and make sure it is. Awesome. We have one single quadrant. Let's do the next single quadrant. All this just to make a reusable algorithm, but oh well. Everything takes time in game development, lots of time. Yes, we got one more quadrant confirmed. Nice, that one's confirmed. All right, it worked. Get rid of this test code. Let's do the for loop. Now we can do something like this, Q0 or 3. That should be southeast, that should be the eastern ones. like it a lot. Now I'm going to make it random. So it's going to be based on a random number. Let's go this. Get rand 1. Based on a position. Why isn't the autocomplete? Come on, autocomplete. I'm lost without you. Put a bunch of traps in your yard. Just don't forget where and what. Yeah. It's a good point, Pedro. There still is, though. Oh, nice. No, it's Kappa. Oh. Yeah, I was just going to say Somali pirates. And also, Indonesian pirates. There are still Indonesian pirates. Okay, get rand 1 based on 0. And then the... Well, let's do... Yeah, 0 is fine. Y is going to be Q. Maybe 1 plus Q. And then all that, if that's less than 128, we're going to do water. Otherwise, we're going to do pillars. There we go. Now we have a random pattern. And we could even do, we could even change the width too. Yeah. Yeah. Yes, 200K, 1998 car. Yes, Steve Tramby. Do you leave it unlocked? I always wish I had a car that I could just leave unlocked. That's like my dream car. Alright, let's play with the width now too. So we'll make the width a little bit random. And the radius and all that. Int r, I'm thinking a radius min of like 3 plus this get ran something, doesn't matter, just based on physical tile in this area. Mod that by perhaps up to 3, so that gives us 0, 1, or 2. So that would be a possible radius of 3 to 5. Or a bunker. Bust out another 1,000, right? Yeah. Okay, the radius that time was 3, I guess. I want to see these actually manual, so I'm going to turn all that off. That should have been, I think that's radius 3. Just buy a decommissioned silo. I usually lock it, but it's mostly habit. Yeah, nice. Yeah, that's radius 3. Let's do radius 4. I've already seen radius 4. Let's do radius 5. Get a solar plane, never land. Yeah, you get a solar plane with your own hydroponic studio on there that grows enough food for you to live on. You just, like, you know, sprinkle your waste all over the land. Radius 5 is kind of nice. I like seeing it bigger like that. It's radius 6. Buy 700 copies of Songbeard. Yeah! Did you guys see the new Archers or season 6 of Archer? Radius 6 is cool too. Man, this radius is going to get really up there. I think maybe even radius 7 might work. Buy 20 NPCs. Yeah. That's still good. Maybe a little much, though, for the pattern 1 dot, but let's see radius 8. Radius 8 and 9 might even work. Yeah, there's a season 6, man. Keyword yet. Still on the 2 watch list? I recommend it. I like it. It's pretty funny. Yeah, oh, there, that's pretty good. That's like the bare minimum, I'd say. 8. Alright, cool. 8 it is. So if I start with 3, I can add up to 7. And that would give me the 8, but I want to do 6 in this case. Okay, there's pattern puzzle 1 dot. Here's pattern puzzle 2 dot. Wait, what if the unlit pillar was right at the center? Archer is a cartoon show, but it's for adults. Yes, it's a spy-themed cartoon show. Oh, you know what? That's the center. It should be centered Y plus 1. That actually looks better. All right, and that's how you take... That's how you do flexible algorithms. This is a procedurally generated game, but it's a flexible algorithm that can change with different seeds. Different seeds of the game will look different. This room will be completely different. Okay, let's go to the next room, which has a puzzle in it. This one. The radius is gonna need to be bigger for this one. This is the pattern diamond. I think the minimum, let's try the minimum radius 3. That's going to be too small, but let's see. Lightweight solar drones. You have you sleep 4 hours sometimes? Steve Trammy, that's crazy. Enough that you would actually hurt the pillar all the way. I can't tell if I'm hurting them or not. Run away! I think these are invincible. Okay, anyways, the radius is definitely too small at 3. Let's do at least 4. Thanks, old and tired. Oh, he refused. What? Bomb deal. Oh, that's your 4 hour sleep medicine. Oh. Thanks, Pedro. Yeah, so that radius is too small as well. So I'm just going to finish these two patterns here, and that'll be it for today's stream. So probably another 5 or 10 minutes on today's stream. And yeah, I want to get this a little bit wrapped up before I call it dinner time. Thanks, old and tired. Appreciate you saying that, man. I hope if you do end up buying it and playing it, I hope you enjoy at least what you do get played. All right, yeah, this is looking good with this radius minimum of 5. So let's do 5. I bet you the radius can go all the way to 9 on this one. Let's see what 9 looks like. Nope, that's too much. 8 was the limit. Okay, so it's 5, plus up to 8, which would be 3, so I need to mod 4. There we go. We got a pattern diamond. Done. Let's see what this looks like for this pattern. Yeah, cool. That just makes this whole area now look so much more interesting than it did 5 minutes ago. You know, before it was just these pillars and stuff, and that was cool. But just seeing these exterior pillars on the outside and some extra bushes and stuff really makes the area look a lot more interesting. The only thing I have left to do here on this area is to make it so it isn't so orange when all of these pillars are lit. But I want to come to a stopping point here in today's stream, so I'm going to go to the other one and we'll make sure this one looks good too. I know, that's why it's a stressful job, exactly. Puzzle, 2 dots. I'm thinking this one should be 3 plus up to 7. Maybe 4. We'll do 4 plus 6. Just make it a little different than the other ones. And then we got 2 unlit pillars. This one will be center X minus 3. This one will be center X plus 3. And we should do something like this for this one too. We'll do 5 plus 5 for that one. Yeah. This one went with a really huge radius for its choice. Let's see what it looks like with a really small radius, though, just to make sure. I think that was the maximum radius it could possibly do. There's the minimum radius. I guess that works. Still walk by, light these on fire. Cool. Done. Today's stream is done. So to recap what I did today, what I'll continue doing today, what I'm gearing up for tomorrow is a Steam update. So hopefully, I think tomorrow I'll do a playthrough. So tomorrow's stream, same time, is going to be a playthrough, including all this new stuff. There's a new NPC named Brutus, which Steve Tramby designed. That was his Kickstarter reward. And there's this other NPC named Zero, which is part of this dungeon. And then there's these swordless dungeons. There's a lot that's new in the game. So this is a pretty big update, and there's going to be a lot of bugs I'm going to have to fix, I guarantee. So what I'm going to fix up tonight, to finish this all up, I really need to at least go into this area over here and fix this place. So this is not looking good yet. I want to finish the pattern. So there'll be a pattern around here or something to make it look more interesting. You can't really walk yet, right, nicely around this door. So I need to make it so you can walk right. And also it should all shift down a little bit because there's so much of this art you can't even see. And lastly, when you go into the meditative stance, I don't have meditate here at this point. But anyways, when you go into your meditative stance, there's a cool animation I'm going to do when you actually unlock a door with it. So that's what I'm working on. I'm basically getting this swordless dungeon working so I can try it out for tomorrow's playthrough. And then hopefully get the Steam update finished by tomorrow night, which would be like Saturday morning for a lot of you guys. There'll be a Steam update. Or Friday night for some of you guys, there'll be a Steam update this week. So That's it, you guys. Hope you all have a great evening, and thanks for watching. Appreciate you all so much. Talk to you later.